everyone. I am Rama. In this lecture, I am going to give an example for how to use Jacobi method to find the eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvectors. Let us see the problem. Find the eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvectors of A equal to 1, root 2, 2, first row, root 2, 3, root 2, second row, 2, root 2, 1, third row, using Jacobi method. So before going to use Jacobi method, we need to check that whether A is a symmetric or not. It is very clear that A transpose equals to A. Hence, A is said to be symmetric matrix. Thus, we can use Jacobi method. In this Jacobi method, the iteration formula to find rotation matrix BK is equals to SK inverse BK minus 1 SK, where K is equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on. When K is equals to 1, we can see that B1 is equals to S1 inverse B0 S1. This B0 is nothing but always the given matrix A. Since this is an iteration formula, each time we need to find the matrix SK, and then we need to find the product SK inverse BK minus 1 SK, so that the resultant matrix BK should be in the form of a diagonal matrix, so that the diagonal elements of BK are taken as the eigenvalues of the given matrix A. Let us start finding rotation matrices. First rotation, which is given by B1 equal to S1 inverse B0 S1, nothing but S1 inverse A S1. To find this product, we need to find the matrix S1. Let us find that matrix. Now in the given matrix, we need to choose the largest off diagonal element. In the matrix A, 1, 3, 1 are the diagonal elements. In the previous lecture, I have already explained that we need to consider off diagonal elements above the diagonal. There are 3 off diagonal elements, root 2, 2, root 2. Among these, 2 is the largest value. So here we have all the values are positive. These elements may be positive or negative. We must take the absolute values of those elements, and then we need to take the maximum one. Here we have mod root 2, mod 2, modulus of root 2 again. So anyhow, we are going to get 2 is the largest element from the off diagonal elements. This 2 is located in the first row, third column. So its position can be taken as A13. The position is A13. Now we need to take the elements. Let us take 1, 3 horizontally and vertically. Now we can see elements positions. 1, 1. We should consider the element A11. And then 1, 3. We should consider the element A13. And then 3, 1. Consider the element A31. And then 3, 3. A33 element. Now these 4 elements A11, A13, A31, A33. Are to be replaced by cos theta in place of A11 in place of A13 minus sin theta, and in place of A31 sin theta in place of A33 cos theta. Whatever the matrix S1 is formed, that is always the order same as A, the given matrix. Here in a 3x3 matrix, 4 elements are being covered by cos theta minus sin theta, cos theta. Still some diagonal elements and off diagonal elements are there. Then all the diagonal elements are to be replaced by 1 and off diagonal elements are to be placed by 0. So that our matrix S1 will become A11 cos theta, A13 minus sin theta, and A31 third row first column sin theta, third row third column cos theta. Now in a 3x3 matrix, there is one diagonal element place is vacant. This place is to be filled with 1. and four off diagonal elements are vacant. They are to be filled with 0. Now in this matrix S1, theta is to be determined. That can be determined using the conditions whether A11 is same as A33 or different, and then the sign of A13. Let us see that in the given matrix. In the given matrix, A11 is 1, A33 is 1, both are same, and then A13 is positive, so that we must take theta as positive. A11, A33 is 1 and A13 is positive, so that theta is taken as pi by 4. This can be obtained from the formula theta is equals to half tan inverse of 2. Whatever the largest element is chosen, that is to be taken here by A11, the diagonal elements of 2 by 2 submatrix, minus A33. A13 is taken as 2, which is positive, and A11 equal to A33, this is going to be 0. Something by 0 is infinity, so this is half tan inverse of infinity, nothing but half into pi by 2, pi by 4 it is, so that theta is taken as pi by 4. Let us use theta value in the matrix S1, so that it will become S1 equal to cos pi by 4, 0 minus sin pi by 4 first row, 0, 1, 0, second row, sin pi by 4, 0, cos pi by 4, third row. We know the values of this sin pi by 4 and cos pi by 4. So that S1 is going to be 1 by root 2, 0, minus 1 by root 2, first row, 0, 1, 0, second row, 1 by root 2, 0, 1 by root 2 is third row. And this is our matrix S1. It is very clear that S1 is orthogonal, so that S1 transpose equals to S1 inverse. How to check this? No need to find S1 inverse and then showing that S1 inverse equal to S1 transpose. Simply by observing the columns of S1, we can decide whether S1 is orthogonal or not. Since there are 3 columns in S1, we can form 3 pairs from these columns. Let us take the first pair. Let us check whether this first pair is orthogonal. Multiply corresponding elements and then add them. We will get 0. So that the first pair is orthogonal. Let us take the second pair. Multiply corresponding elements and then add them. We will get 0. So that second pair is also orthogonal. Let us take the third pair. Multiply corresponding elements. You will get minus 1 by 2 plus 0 plus 1 by 2. It is going to be 0. So that S1 is said to be orthogonal. So directly we can take S1 inverse equal to S1 transpose. Since S1 inverse is obtained, so that the first rotation B1 is S1 inverse AS1 is nothing but S1 transpose AS1. We need to write transpose of S1 and given matrix A and then S1. We need to find the product of 3 matrices. I am not showing that how to find the product. I am directly giving the result, the product of the 3 matrices. We are getting B1 as 3, 2, 0 first row, 2, 3, 0 second row, 0, 0, minus 1 third row. It is very clear our B1 is not a diagonal matrix. So whatever the process is done onto the matrix A, the same is to be repeated for the matrix B1. So we can find the second rotation matrix. In general formula, we put K equal to 2. So B2 is equals to S2 inverse B1 S2. Now our task is B1 is known, that is obtained in first step. S2 is to be determined using the matrix B1. From B1, we can see 3, 3, minus 1 are the diagonal elements. And we consider off diagonal elements above the diagonal. They are 2, 0, 0. Among the 3 elements, 2 is the largest element in magnitude. Its location is first row, second column, nothing but A12. We are taking that element as A12 equal to 2, which is greater than 0. So we need to form the matrix S2, which is of order 3 in such a way that we need to replace the elements. This A12, let us place 1, 2 horizontally and vertically. Now we should consider the elements. 1, 1, nothing but A11. 1, 2 is A12. 2, 1, it is A21. 2, 2, it is A22. These four elements are to be replaced by cos theta minus sin theta, sin theta cos theta. In a 3x3 matrix, there are some diagonal elements and off-diagonal elements. All the diagonal elements are to be replaced by 1 and off-diagonal elements by 0. So that S2 can be written as A11 is cos theta, A12 is minus sin theta, 0. This is off-diagonal element. And A21 sin theta, A22 cos theta, off-diagonal element, 0. And then off-diagonal elements, zeros, diagonal element 1. This is S2. In this, theta is to be determined. To determine theta value, we need to check whether A11 equal to A22 or both are not equal. And then the sign of A12. Let us compare the matrix B1 with the elements A11, A12, A13, etc. In such a case, A11, A22, both are equal to 3. And then A12 is 2, which is positive. So that theta is equals to pi by 4. A11, A22 is 3 and A12 is positive. Then theta equal to pi by 4. So that S2 can be written as cos pi by 4 minus sin pi by 4, 0 first row, sin pi by 4, cos pi by 4, 0 second row, 0, 0, 1 third row. We know the values of sin pi by 4, cos pi by 4. Then we get S2 as 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2, 0 first row, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0 second row, 0, 0, 1 third row. Here also we can check whether the columns of S2 are pairwise orthogonal. Take the first column. Multiply corresponding elements and then add them. We get 0. Again, next pair 0, 0, 0. It is 0. And the last pair, multiply corresponding elements and then add, we get 0. So directly we can write down that S2 is orthogonal matrix. So that S2 inverse equals to S2 transpose. As S2 is been obtained, we find the second rotation matrix B2, which is given by S2 inverse B1 S2. Since S2 inverse equal to S2 transpose, we get B2 from S2 transpose B1 S2. Find the product of three matrices, we get the matrix. The resultant matrix B2 as 5, 0, 0 first row, 0, 1, 0 second row, 0, 0, minus 1 third row. Since this is in the form of a diagonal matrix, then we stop finding rotation matrices. The iteration process is stopped and we stop finding BKs. This D is similar to the matrix A. So that the diagonal elements of D, nothing but B2, are taken as the eigenvalues of given matrix A. If here it is not in the diagonal matrix form, then again we need to apply the same process for the matrix B2. We may be getting B3, B4, etc. Till we get BK in the form of a diagonal matrix, we need to continue the same process by which we got all the eigenvalues of a 3x3 matrix. Now we need to find the corresponding eigenvectors, for which we are finding the matrices S1, S2 and so on. So we need to take their product. That means we need to find S is equals to S1, S2, S3 and so on. But in this problem, we got only two matrices S1, S2. So S is being obtained from S1, S2. So we are just multiplying the two matrices S1 and S2. The resultant matrix is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by root 2 first row, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0 second row, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, 1 by root 2 third row. Simply, the columns of S are said to be the eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalues of E. That means the first column is the eigenvector corresponding to the first diagonal element, nothing but the eigenvalue I, 5. The second column is the eigenvector corresponding to the second diagonal element, 1. Third column is the eigenvector corresponding to third diagonal element. So by this step we got all the eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvectors of the given matrix A. Here we can observe that the eigenvalues of A are distinct and A is a symmetric matrix. We have one property that the eigenvectors corresponding to distinct eigenvalues of a symmetric matrix are always orthogonal. Even that condition can be checked here. We can take the first two columns. We can multiply corresponding elements and then add them. We see we will be getting 0. And take the next pair. Again we will get 0. Take the third pair. Again we get 0. Simply the eigenvectors are satisfying the condition that they are pairwise orthogonal. This is the Jacobi method to get all the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a real symmetric matrix. Thank you.